Skelton 803. Take one.
Now, from Television City in Hollywood, the Red Skelton Hour. With the Tom Hansen dancers, the Alan Copeland singers, David Rose and his orchestra, tonight's musical guest, Shirley Bassey, our special guest star, Maurice Evans, Oliver Shagnasty, Cauliflower McPugg, and here he is, Red Skelton.
Ladies and gentlemen, I feel good tonight. Hey, we have one of the little fellas on the show here that works here. His name's Peter, and he loves to play tennis, see? So we went over to the tennis court the other day, and there was nobody there. So he says, this fella stutters, by the way. He says, is there anybody here I could play this game with? And he says, yeah, Pete. He says, over there is a girl that stutters, too. You'll make a great team. So he goes over and he says, pardon me, the pro says I could play this game with you. He says, my name's Peter, but I'm not a saint. She says, well, glad to meet you. My name's Mary, but I'm not a very good tennis player. I was over at the post office. A little guy came in. He says, I want $10 worth of stamps. And the guy says, what denomination? He says, since when you have to tell your religion to mail a letter? Hey, I was over at the supermarket. Over the supermarket, and there was a terrible fight over there. A big fight over there. One of the Los Angeles Dodgers tried to buy the breakfast food of champions. Hey, at the supermarket, they have a game over there called roulette. One lady came in, and she got so excited that she bet everything she had in her push cart, and she lost 3 cans of beans and a kid. I live down in Cathedral City here in California, see? And now, every Wednesday at this little store, they have a special sale for women only, see? And it's fun. Attention, counter 6 having sale on canned goods. Well, I'm going to tell you, the way those women push and shove, it's ridiculous. One almost tore my dress right off my back. Thank you. I'd like to thank my relatives who have gathered here. Lady walks into the butcher shop. She says, the lady, how much are your turkeys? He says, 45 cents a pound. She says, I can get them down the street for 26 pounds, 26 cents. She says, go there and get them. She says, they don't have any. He says, when I don't have any, I only charge 10 cents. My wife, Little Red, went in to buy some meat the other day. She saw this sign, says, steaks, 29 cents a pound. She says, what kind of meat is it? He says, what kind do you think it is? She says, I don't know, but I don't think it's beef. She says, do you want to bet? She says, no, I don't bet. I never won on a horse in my life. Hey, things are getting so expensive. There were two guys, robbers. They walk into this supermarket, and one of them looked at the price of meat, and he says, I think we can get away with what we're doing. See, two robbers, they walk. Gertrude and Heathcliff, the two seagulls, they're talking to them. Hey, did you hear the news about Gwendolyn the cow? Gwendolyn the cow. She's suing the matrimonial agency. She is? Suing the matrimonial agency? Why? Well, from wrong advice they gave. Wrong advice. It's wrong advice? Yeah, they gave her a bum steer. Hey, with the way prices are with meat today, I would like now to do a little pantomime, if I may, of a fellow walking with his dog. He goes in to buy some meat, steak, a $10 worth of steak. And this is a little pantomime. Here we go.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Shirley Bassey with the Tom Hanson Dancers.
When the neighbor shuns you, there's the kind of walk you walk that you above the crowd. There's the kind of walk you walk when somebody loves you. That's very much like walking on a cloud. Good fortune found you, Chappie, and your life's a happy world seem fine.
Let's go slumming, take us slumming. We'll be bumming round Park Avenue. Happy hobos from St. Paul to Tallahassee, rubbing elbows with the likes of Shirley Bassey.
Classy! There's the kind of walk you walk when you feel like crowing. There's the kind of walk you walk when you're on your way. There's the kind of walk you walk when your pride is showing. There's the kind of walk you walk when today's your day. There's the kind of walk you walk when the world's all rainbow. Walking happy.
We now present our distinguished guest, Mr. Maurice Evans, as Professor Whitecliff, along with Bolivar Shagnasty, played by Red Skelton, and Cauliflower McPugg, played by Red Skelton, in Cauliflower Fiddles While Bolivar Burns.
What a mess! Why did I ever rent this place to those two? Bolivar, Bolivar Shagnasty.
Good morning, Dan. Mrs. Bond, how do you do?
This apartment's filthy, and the Board of Health Inspector's coming.
I got news for you. The Board of Health's already been here, and they've classified this place as...
You're the sloppiest thing I've ever seen.
You ever look in a mirror? Now, don't get nasty. Remember, I'm the guy that found that the lump in the mattress was your last tenant. That's what me. I'm hurt.
Oh, I'm sorry, officer. I saw him throw it from up there.
All right now, Shagnasty. According to my records, you're 3 months behind in the rent. What do you say to that?
I'd say you're a pretty good bookkeeper. I had it figured that way, too, you know.
I need money.
Oh, you
my
do?
Husband's out of work, and my daughter's going to have a baby, and my son's in jail.
What are you doing here? You ought to be on Peyton Place. If that ain't Sophia Lauren, stay out. Well, hi, sophisticated.
Hi, dilapidated. Now, what kind of talk was that? Hi, Mrs. Bond. Mm. Boy, when are you going to fumigate this joint?
What do you mean, fumigate? We don't have to. We've all had our distemper shot.
That reminds me. I got a date at the decontamination chamber. Yeah.
Careful the tree. I just pruned it. Blooming.
Volibar, I guess you know my mother doesn't approve of my going to a man's apartment.
Mm.
Fortunately, she didn't say nothing about a pig pen.
Make yourself at home.
Bolivar, I come here to get something settled. When are you and me getting married?
Well, truthfully, between you and me, I think love is silly.
Between you and me, love is ridiculous.
You're proud of that, ain't you?
Now, I mean it, Bolivar. When are you going to make some money so we can get married?
Well, I'm having a little trouble right now with my fighter, Cauliflower McPugg. He don't want to fight no more. Seems like he's some broken-down tutor is taking a hold of him and going to make a fiddle player out of him. He plays the violin now. He says he has the makings of another golden boy. Truthfully, I don't think he could make a brass cuspidor. Listen at that.
What's that?
That's either McPug's violin or somebody's mugging a cat. I don't know. That's probably the termites taking up tap dancing. Come in!
Great! I think I stepped into a litter can.
No, no, this is a comfort station for hippies. They come in here to change dirt.
Yes, I shouldn't be surprised. You know, if you cleaned up this place a little, it'd make a magnificent flower dump.
Oh, it would, huh? Who are you, Mr. Clean or something?
I am Professor Wycliffe.
Oh, your professor's tone-deaf music teacher, huh?
Sir, I am a disseminator of the arts for those who indulge in fisticuffs.
Oh?
I taught Gene Tunney to read Shakespeare, Mickey Walker to paint Cassius Clay to write poetry.
Look, Charlie, I don't want no ding-a-ling professor taking my fighter and turning him into a long hair.
Heavens to Hemingway, he used two double negatives.
I did? Well, look, Ah, go on. Your mother picks her teeth with a horseshoe. Look, I got no time to argue. I'll see you later. I got a higher echelon meeting down at the pool hall. sit down. Make yourself at home.
Where?
Where? Here.
Whoa.
I'll see you later, Moigle. I'll see you later. Hey, next year, maybe apples.
Lovely chap. If I were his father, I'd look for a loophole in his birth certificate. Would you kindly tell Mr. McPugg I'm here?
Ain't I seen you someplace before?
Ain't I seen you someplace before?
No, I asked you first.
Miss, I could be of assistance if you're interested in a theatrical career.
Really? You know, I used to be a dancer, but I had to give it up. I kept catching cold.
Yes, those tassels don't give much warmth, do they? Miss, would you excuse me? It's time for the lesson. Cauliflower! Cauliflower! Mr. McPugg!
Boy, you're really new around here. There's only one way to get him.
Show me.
Where is the bomb? Let me at him. Let me at him. I'll kill the bomb. Hey, I like the footwork. I like the footwork. Wait.
Okay, referee, tell the Scotchman to take off the kilts and fight and regulate and drunk. Come on.
Cauliflower, it's me, Moidle.
Oh, you lost your Scotch accent in a hurry.
Cauliflower, calm down. That's not a fighter, that's a goyle.
What?
Girl.
Is that a goyle? That's a girl? Oh, boy, what they won't think of next. I thought it was a soft boy. I didn't know.
You punchy.
What do you mean I'm punchy? You think I'm punchy? You ought to see some of them wrestlers down at the gym there. Every Saturday they slide down the banister.
Well, what's wrong with that?
There's no banister in that gym.
I know. I polish it every Friday. Now, some of them fighters, they stay in the ring too long, they start hearing bells and boys. But not me, boy. I'll give up the old fight game before I start hearing bells and boys. Watch out! Oh, fuck!
Yeah, remind me to order a computer.
Sir?
A computer.
What for?
Just so we can reprogram your head and raise your IQ to idiot.
Oh, good, then I can run for office.
Well,
I like that footwork. Isn't that dumb?
Come along. Time for your lesson.
Oh, it is? Oh, my God.
Say, do you really think he has any talent?
At $5 a yes'm?
Yeah.
Well, I'm getting out of here. I'm a music lover.
Say, Professor, is it too late to change to the piano?
Why do you want to change to the piano?
My beer can keeps sliding off of my fiddle.
Tell you now, how can you live with yourself?
I ain't got twin beds.
Now, have you been doing your scales?
Oh, yes. I weigh in now at 210.
Why don't you use your head?
I did. If I didn't, I'd weigh in at 209, you know.
Well, now, please, Cauliflower, may we begin?
Begin. All right, there. We'll play a little tune here for you. Yeah.
No, 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 no. No, you're doing it backwards.
Try it this way, then. Okay.
No, Cauliflower, you've got them in the wrong hands.
These are the only hands I got, you nut.
I have to put up with this. I, who taught Ed Sullivan how to register emotion. There now. Play.
Oh. Right, I'll play. Yeah, I'll give you a little dolo. Oh. Hey, that's no fair. He hit me before the bell rang.
I should have listened to my mother. She wanted me to be a catbird. Yeah. All right, now, let me hear you play the scales.
The scales, all right.
Can't you play any higher?
Not and stay on the floor, no. Whoop, there goes another one. That was a peacock that time. What's he doing on this network? Oh, the second round, hold the guy. I'll get the bum.
No, 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 no. That's the telephone.
Oh, the telephone. Well, why don't it ring? What in the coinkadinky? The phone just rang. All right, I'll get it. I'll get it. Yeah?
Cauliflower, this is Bob. Now, I'm going to fight for you. Yeah? You're filling in tomorrow at the arena.
Oh, how about that? How about that? Tomorrow, I'm filling in an arena. Me in an arena. Me in an arena. How do you like that? Me in what an arena?
Cauliflower, I will not permit you to fight. I will not allow those delicate hands in a boxing ring. Under my tutelage, you are going to turn into a virtuoso.
I am? Well, will I have to have Egypt for an operating like that?
No, just come as you are. Oh. But you can't fight, Cauliflower. Okay, you can't fight. Look, besides... You're not in condition.
You think I'm not in condition? Now you wait till you see me after the fight, buddy.
I'll stop that fight if it's the last thing I do.
We may be even. It may be the last thing I do, you know.
Is that your footwork?
No, my shorts are a little tight here.
Let's try it again. Once again.
Won't you come home, Bill Bailey? Won't you come home?
Bailey's the name. Bill Bailey. And I'm home. You can put the cat out and let me in now.
You stop annoying my singer.
Oh, singer? Dressed like that?
You run your business your way, I'll run my business mine.
Oh, how'd I get you to walk through the park, huh?
Mr. Shagnasty, I thought you were engaged to Miss Myrtle.
You run your business your way, I'll run mine my way.
Well, I think that'll be all for today. Thank you, Miss Streisand.
Streisand? She looks like a half a bottle of ketchup. She sure carries a nice tune, I'll tell you that. Say, look, Professor, now you're trying to stop my fighter from going into the ring tonight, but I ain't going to stand for it. Do you understand? I ain't going to stand for it.
Marvelous. Marvelous. Say that again.
You heard me. I says I ain't going to stand for it.
I ain't going to stand for it. What projection, what command, what tonal quality.
Who, me?
Oh, me. What a way you have with words. How you would you like to become an actor?
An actor? Is that the same as an actor?
Yes, in some manner. The way you talked, Mr. Shagnasty, I feel that you're on the brink of a great career.
Really?
Permit me to audition you in a little Shakespeare.
Oh, a little Shakespeare.
Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears.
Friend?
Not yet. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him.
Friend?
Not yet. The evil the men do lives after them. The good is often interred with their bones.
Could I speak to an enemy?
So let it be whispered. The noble Brutus hath told you Caesar was ambitious. If it was so, it was a grievous fault, and grievously hath Caesar answered it.
Could I have my teeth back?
Gad, that felt good. One doesn't get a chance to work in Shakespeare anymore.
They don't.
No, I'm going to make an actor out of you after all.
Oh, well, that's
now,
pretty good.
The first thing you must do is to give up the fight game.
I'll do it. Oh, I get it. You're trying to trick me so you can turn McPugg into a rotten fiddle player, ain't you?
Now, come. Let's talk this over like two gentlemen of the theater, shall we?
Not on your life, buddy.
I have a fine stock of whiskey in there.
Maybe we ought to sit down and talk this over like a couple of gentlemen of the theater, huh? Hey, I would like that acting stuff. How do you like this? How now, brown booze?
Help yourself.
Hey, sit in your closet. Let me out of here. Hey, I'll suffocate. Help. Hey, wait a minute. Who's in here?
Won't you come home, Bill Bailey? You come home.
Now, where's that Cauliflower McPugg?
Oh, here he comes now. It's about time.
What on earth are you doing on that stretch?
Well, I usually go out of the wing that way. I thought I'd come in that way.
Yeah, help me in the wing, will you, Dad? Help me in the wing. Raise up the rope there for me, will you,
brother? Will you? Ladies and gentlemen, in this corner, Violent Vic Poik. Cauliflower McPugg.
Oh, they love me. They love me.
Defending his title as a heavyweight champion in the Campfire Goyle division.
All right, fellas, now listen to me. I want to explain a few things to you, see. Now, I got certain regulations, you know, and you understand what I...
You know the rules. Oh, don't worry about the rules. You can count on me.
Oh, I intend to.
Yeah.
Hey, I can't go through with it, fight.
What's come over you?
Goose pimple.
Wait a minute, fellas. Help me in the ring here.
Help him in the ring. Help him in the ring, buddy.
Thank you. I want to test this man's gloves.
What do you think?
Sounds like E flat to me.
Yeah. Oh, duck, everybody. Here come the flock of them.
Boy, you think there's some kind of an omen? There was a vulture in that group.
Listen, Cauliflower. Listen carefully.
What's that?
To save yourself,
yeah.
Why don't you make believe you've been hit and fall down?
Good heavens. There's a leak somewhere. They know my strategy.
Oh, Lord, he talked to you, huh?
Give me the old monkey workout.
I say, old chap, here comes another flucker.
Another flucker.
Where's my hat? Where's my hat?
Here you are. Here you are. Play a little. It'll relax you.
Play? All right, then.
Come on, everyone. Do-si-do, do-si-do. Elevate left, elevate right. Swing your partner. That's right. Parade.
All right, park this out now. Onward to fight. Let's go.
Onward to fight. All right.
Boy, am I glad I bet on you.
Oh, I am.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10.
What happened to 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9?
Lay down, you're out. The winner, Cauliflower McPugg and his magic violin.
Maurice Evans, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, you know, my doctor uses these for surgical gloves.
You know, Fred, I must say, I was impressed with the way you handled that violin. No, not the way you played it. Oh. The way you handled it.
Well, you know, I came from a musical family.
Yeah?
You know that? Yes. I had an uncle who studied the violin for 10 years.
Well, he must have been pretty good.
No, 9 of those years, he thought you blew in it.
My goodness, what did your aunt say to that?
I'm glad you asked. She had a harp.
Don't tell me she blew in a harp.
No, she sliced hard-boiled eggs. Maurice, I want to thank you for being here tonight, but before you go, how about a little more from Shakespeare, huh?
Oh, certainly, Red. Uh-huh. To be or not to be, that is the question.
No, 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 that's been changed. Nowadays, it's for if or not for if, that is the question. Ladies and gentlemen, and now England's international singing star, Miss Shirley Bassey.
You will. My nose pressed up against the window.
curse on you. May your favorite belly dancer drop the ruby in your soup.
Hands off my husband.
Yeah.
Shut up, you dog of an infidel.
Ah, you've got it wrong. I'm the dog of an infidel. She is the pussycat of an infidel.
Listen, our noble master, the Sheik Ali Ben Ali, say you stay here till he arrives.
He say that, huh?
He say that.
Sure he say it that way?
He say it that way.
I tell you, you Arabs may know arithmetic, but you don't know much about the grammar, do you?
And you try to escape, we chop you up.
Oh, no. Good heavens. What a horrible fate. End up as a camel burger.
Honey, be nice to them. Maybe they'll help us.
They'll help us, huh? Okay. Tell me, how's your sand crop this year?
I told you the sheik will make you die 1,000 deaths.
Yeah. That's pretty dull. You've been shaving your legs again, haven't you? Die 1,000 deaths. You've got to help me. You've got to help me.
Oh, honey, don't be such a coward.
I'm not a coward, but 1,000 deaths. Do you know what funerals cost these days?
We will slit your throat.
Huh?
We'll cut out your tongue and pluck out your eyes.
Thank heavens there's no more violence on television. Don't worry. They didn't see the knife.
Now, listen, honey. There's nothing to worry about. The sheik will probably want ransom from us, so when he gets here, just offer him lots of money, and he'll set us free.
You out of your cotton-picking mind? This guy is the richest guy in the world. He's got more money than anybody else. He sells J. Paul Getty oil. He sells Howard Hughes sneakers.
Then why were we kidnapped?
Oh. I've been keeping the truth from you, I must tell you. This is serious. I didn't want to keep this from you. You weigh about 110. I didn't want to keep this from you, but Billy and Allie. All right, if the undertone tittering don't stop, I'll clear the hall. I don't know if you know this or not, but I'm trying to impress Maurice Evans. Ah, now I found out who the ringleader is.
Now.
Wait just a minute. I'm going to do something for these folks. I've been rehearsing all day. I'm going to do something. I'm going to leap up in the air, and she's going to hold me in the air. Now, I've never done this before. I may kill myself. Now, if you folks don't mind, I'll take my applause now. You think I'm going to kill myself for that kind of applause?
Now,
I'll tell you what it is. Ali bin Ali wants you for his harem.
We must escape.
We could just cut our way out of here. That's what I'll do. I'll cut my way out of here. Did you hear anything from the front office?
Somebody's asking me to take a cut.
But the hard way. Look, you don't have to worry. I've prepared for the worst. Here, take this gun. And if that rotten old sheik starts anything, then you'll be able to shoot him and save yourself.
Oh, I'll shoot him.
Shoot.
I'll shoot to kill.
Shoot to
yes.
kill.
Yes.
I think he's coming now.
Really?
Are you Ali bin Ali?
Quiet, you Western dog.
Why, I like this fellow myself.
But what beauty have we here? Like the morning dew touching a rose of elegance.
Maybe you better stay here. But if you can make love like that, you can ride a camel. Not used to girls, fella?
Enjoy this now, because you're never going to see it on the air. Okay, well, go ahead. You're on your way to the harem. Shoot! And now, ladies and gentlemen, with great pride, I introduce our distinguished guest star, Shakespearean actor Maurice Evans, in a presentation of the famous American classic, The Shooting of Dan McGrew.
A bunch of the boys were whooping it up in the Malamute Saloon. The kid that handles the music box was hitting a jagtime tune. Back at the bar in a solo game sat Dangerous Dan McGrew. And watching his luck was his lighter love, the lady that's known as Lou. When out in the night, which was 50 below, and into the din and the glare, there stumbled a miner, fresh from the creeks, dog dirty and loaded for bear. There was none could place the stranger's face, though we searched ourselves for a clue. But we drank his health, and the last to drink was Dangerous Dan McGrew. There's men that somehow just grip your eyes and hold them hard like a spell. And such was he, and he looked to me like a man who'd lived in hell. Then I got to figuring who he was and wondering what he'd do. And I turned my head, and there watching him was a lady that's known as Lou. His eyes went rubbering around the room, and he seemed in a kind of a daze. Till at last, that old piano fell in the way of his wandering gaze. In a buckskin shirt that was glazed with dirt, he sat, and I saw him sway. Then he clutched the keys with his talon hands. My God, that man could play. Were you ever out in the great alone when the moon was awful clear and the icy mountains hemmed you in with a silence you most could hear? While high overhead, green, yellow, and red, the north lights swept in bars, then you've a hunch what the music meant. Hunger and night and the stars. And hunger not of the belly kind that's banished with bacon and beans, but the gnawing hunger of lonely men for a home and all that it means, for a woman dearer than all the world and true as heaven is true. God, how ghastly she looks through her rouge, the lady that's known as Lou. Then on a sudden the music changed so soft that you scarce could hear, but you felt that your life had been looted clean of all that it once held dear, that someone had stolen the woman you loved, that her love was a devil's lie, that your guts were gone, and the best for you was to crawl away and die. 'Twas the crowning cry of a heart's despair, and it thrilled you through and through. I guess I'll make it a spread, Miss Eyre, said Dangerous Dan McGrew. The music almost died away. Then it burst like a pent-up flood, and it seemed to say, repay, repay, and my eyes were blind with blood. The thought came back of an ancient wrong, and it stung like a frozen lash, and the lust awoke to kill, to kill. Then the music stopped with a crash. The stranger turned with a kind of grin, and he spoke, and his voice was calm. And, boys, he says, you don't know me, and none of you care a damn, but I want to state, and my words are straight, and I'll bet my poke they're true, that one of you is a hound of hell, and that one is Dan McGrew. My head and the lights went out. Two guns blazed in the dark and a woman screamed. The lights went up and two men lay stiff and stark. Pitched on his head and pumped full of lead was Dangerous Dan McGrew, while the man from the creeks lay clutched to the breast of the lady that's known as Lou. These are the simple facts of the case, and I guess I ought to know. They say that the stranger was crazed with hooch, and I'm not denying it so. I'm not so wise as the lawyer guys, but strictly between us two, the woman that kissed him and pinched his poke was the lady that's known as Lou.
And now, the silent spot. Red Skelton in the Windstorm.
Thank you. Red will be back in a minute. Here he is again, Red Skelton.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of our sponsors, may we say how proud they are to tell you of their products. Along with the staff, may I say, if during this past hour we've brought you but one second of happiness, then we're proud too. So until next week, we say good night for now, and may God bless. Good night, and thank you.
We have to leave you folks across the nation. May we thank you for your laughter and applause. In a week we'll be returning to your station with a show we know you'll want to see because.
This is Art Gilmore speaking.